Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. So today what I have in store for you is the Global Youth Development Index. Recently Parliament, not exactly the Parliament, but Lok Sabha passed the 127th Amendment Bill. Apart from this, we will be discussing about the new collateral loan scheme, collateral free loan amount that has been provided by RBI under the DNRLM scheme. So these are some of the important questions that we are going to cover today. And apart from these questions, there are other questions as well in this video. So stay tuned till the end to understand what all these news are and how can they be useful for your upcoming examination. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. And this video is particularly for RBI SEBI NABARD, as well as you can use these questions in your banking examinations at the level of PU. So let's begin today's video. But before that, if you haven't subscribed, then do subscribe and hit the bell notification, guys. You can also join this Telegram group because here we will provide you the PDF of this session. Okay. The link of that Telegram group is in description below. So here is our first question. Recently, Global Youth Development Index 2020 has been released by the Commonwealth Secretariat, which assesses the development of youth in a total of 181 countries. Of the 181 countries included on the 2020 Youth Development Index, 156 or 86% recorded improvements in the 8-year period. The global average youth development score improved by 3.1% between 2010 and 2018. All the 181 countries recorded improvement in 5 out of 6 domains, wherein the largest improvement was seen in the health and well-being domain. Which of the following is not a domain of this index? So this is the question for you guys. Out of these many options, you have education, employment and opportunity, public and civic participation, equality and inclusion, and digital intervention. And also one domain is given in the question itself, that is health and well-being. So out of these many options, the right answer here is digital intervention. So digital intervention is not the domain of this index. So what this index has in detail, let us look at that. And also we will be covering these parameters in this index only. Okay. The very first thing are the facts. So this Commonwealth Secretariat. So let me first tell you something about the Commonwealth Secretariat. Commonwealth is basically an apex organization, an organization of a total 54 countries. So these countries had, basically these countries were the countries that were once ruled by the British Empire. So all those countries were given the name Commonwealth. That's why the Commonwealth Games are also held between the countries which were once ruled by the British government. But right now, do remember that this Commonwealth Forum has been opened for other countries as well. Okay, so now the countries which were not ruled by the British government can also become a member of this organization. So right now we have 54 members. It was established in 1965. At present, the head is Patricia Scotland, and the Secretary General is this Patricia Scotland. And the headquarters is in London, UK. So these were the facts about the Commonwealth Secretariat. So this Commonwealth Secretariat, the Commonwealth is the name of the organization. Secretariat is the secretariat located in London, UK. So from there, this report has been released. So this report assesses the improvement in youth development in a total of 181 countries. And out of these 181 countries, 48 countries are Commonwealth countries. Okay, so I hope that this much is clear to you. Now let's move on to the index. So the very first thing is, the youth is defined as the person aged between 15 to 29 years. Okay, but for some countries, the data was available for this much range of people, 15 to 24 years old people. That's not very important for you. It was just for your understanding purpose. Assessment period is 2010 to 18. So growth and development of youth during 2010 to 18, during the 8 year period, is assessed under this index. This we have already discussed. Top Singapore has topped this index for the first time. Bottom pe hai Chad. It is at the very bottom. Okay, so these are the top 10 countries. No need to remember their scores. If you want to remember, then you can just remember the Singapore's score, because this is the first time it has topped this index. So Singapore, Slovenia, Norway, Malta, Denmark, these are the top 5 countries. Understood? These are the parameters. So all of these we have discussed: health and well-being, education, employment and opportunity, political and civic participation, equality and inclusion, peace and security. So guys, all the countries, all the 181 countries have registered an improvement across all the 5 parameters except this political and civic participation. So this one is the only domain where the countries assessed in this index did not register an improvement, rather a decline of 0.18%. So this is a very marginal decline, even though, but it is still a decline. Okay, so only in this parameter or in this domain the decline was seen. And remember that these are the 6 domains, and under these domains 27 indicators were there. Okay. Now let's talk about India. So India's rank is 122 in this index, which is improved from 134th. Last time when the index was released in 2016, their rank was 134th. India's rank on parameters. So the overall score of India is 0.626, which is a very important figure in this index, because direct question can be framed out of this. The next thing is, in terms of education, India's ranking is 119. The score in education is this: employment and opportunity is 139. And then the score is this: equality and inclusion, the ranking is this. The next is India's performance during 2010 to 8 in terms of score. So you can clearly see the score was 5.527, and it has improved to 0.626. So we can see a clear improvement in India's performance in terms of youth development. The top 5 risers, the top 5 countries that have shown an improvement. So Afghanistan is at the top. Then India, Russia, Ethiopia and this Burkina Faso. These are the top 5 improved countries, or the countries which have shown the most improvement in this index. These are the 5 countries that are the worst performers, that have shown the worst, the improvement for the worst. Okay. And these are some of the common observations that I took out from this report. And guys, these observations might not be useful for your phase 1 examination, but they are going to be very useful, particularly if you talk about the phase 1 ESI or phase 2 ESI. Okay, so do listen to me very carefully. According to this report, youth make up 25% of the global working age population, yet they account for 40% of the total unemployment. A major reason of this is that we also include 15 to 20 years of people, and this is the educational age where the people get education. So they do not work, but that is the interpretation. What this report says is a fact, that 25% of the global working population is comprised of youth, and 40% of the total employment also comprises of youth, young people. The global average youth development score improved by 3.1% between this and this. The average improvement in Commonwealth countries, total 48 were assessed in this index, remember, was 2.8%. Of the 181 countries included on this index, 156 recorded improvement in the 8 year period. In 5 out of 6 domains, improvements were recorded in all countries. Largest improvement was seen in health and well-being at 4.39%, whereas political and civic participation was the only domain to record an average global decline that I have told you, 0.18%. So guys, that was all about this Global Youth Development Index. I hope that you have understood the index thoroughly. And now let's move on to the next question. Which city has become the India's first water plus city? Indore, Puri, Gwalior, Ahmedabad, Allahabad. Which one is the right answer? It is Indore. So let me tell you that under the Swachh Sarvekshan for 2021, this certification was given to Indore, which is the latest India's cleanest city. So in the last time Swachh Sarvekshan, Indore was categorized as the cleanest city, and now it has become the India's first water plus city. Now, what is the meaning of water plus city? So water plus city is the certification that is given to a city for having the cleanest rivers and drains. So do remember, water plus refers to a certification that is given under the Swachh Sarvekshan for clean rivers and drains. Now there is a certain criteria that the cities have to fulfill if they want to get this certificate. So what is that criteria? First criteria is that your dirty water should not go into rivers and drain. Second criteria is 30% of the sewage water should be recycled in the state. And third one is that public toilets should be connected with the sewage system and they should be clean. So these are the three criteria that are required to be fulfilled by the cities if they want to get this certification. With which country has India signed an agreement for improving weather forecast in the region by monsoon data analysis? So US, France, UK, Japan, Canada are the options, out of which US is the right answer. So guys, last year in October 2020, Ministry of Earth Sciences and National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration have signed a technical cooperation for earth sciences. For this agreement was signed in October 2020 for technical cooperation in earth sciences and earth science related data. So this agreement that has been signed very recently, this is a follow-up agreement of this MOU which was signed last year by India and US, and the basic purpose is to share the data, monitor the monsoon and improve the weather forecast in the northern Indian Ocean region. So do remember this as well. Okay, so that was all about this question. What is the new limit of collateral free loans which are given to self-help groups under the Day National Rural Livelihood Mission? So guys, this limit is set by RBI recently and it has been raised from 10 lakhs to 20 lakhs. So the right answer is option D. Now, in yesterday's video only, our faculty, Mr. Manish Mishra, has taught you this scheme in detail. So I would recommend you guys to go and watch that session on this Day NRLM scheme, because that session has comprehensively detailed about this scheme. Moving on to the next question. Recently, Lok Sabha has passed the 127th Constitutional Amendment Bill 2021 with a good majority. Which of the following issue is this bill related to? Cooperative societies, socially and educationally backward communities, inclusion of Bodo, Dogri, Maithili and Santhali languages in the 8th schedule of the Constitution, constitutionalizing National Commission for Scheduled Tribes, municipalities, urban local government. So which one of the issues is being catered to by this 127th Constitutional Amendment Bill 2021? So the right answer here is option B, socially and educationally backward communities. Remember that once this bill is passed by the Rajya Sabha too, or assented by the President too, then it will become an act. So it will become the 105th Constitutional Amendment Act 2021. Remember this number, 105th Constitutional Amendment Act. Now you don't have to go into too much of its too much detail in this amendment bill, because we are not law students, guys. You are banking students. So the maximum question that can be framed out of this bill is this much only. And you also need to know that basically this 105th amendment bill is, we can say, is ratifying or clarifying the 102nd Constitutional Amendment Act of 2018. So in this act, basically two major provisions were there. First one is Article 338B, which gives the National Commission for Backward Classes the constitutional status. So this is, this remains as it is. Okay. The next one is Article 342A. So this gives the power to the president to appoint or classify any backward class as the OBC. Okay, in consultation with the government. So the people were saying, the state governments were saying that you are taking away our powers of classifying the OBC community. So in the wake of this dispute between the center and the state, this 105th Constitutional Amendment Bill Act, or sorry, 127th Constitutional Amendment Bill has been introduced and passed by the Lok Sabha already. Okay. And also remember that recently Supreme Court had given this judgment wherein it has upheld the 102nd Constitutional Amendment Act, that central government has the power to classify any OBC community and state government does not have that power. And this decision came in the light of Maratha reservation. Now this is not very important for you all, it is just for your understanding purpose. But the things that you need to remember is the numbers, if you can, the issue with which this is related, and the Constitutional Act which is being clarified through this 105th Constitutional Amendment Act. Now from this question only, I'm going to ask two questions from you which can be of relevance for your upcoming NABARD examination as well. So what are these questions? First one is that you would know that Kaka Kalekar Commission, this was the first commission that was formed to classify or identify the backward classes. Then there was BP Mandal Commission, which was also formed to classify the backward classes, and on the recommendations of BP Mandal Commission, only 27% reservation was given to OBCs. You have to tell me the year of formation of both of these committees in the comment section below. This is your task for the day. And guys, here this session ends. I hope that you have enjoyed the session. Thank you so much for watching it.